to round four of the Parenting Roundabout podcast for the week of September 23rd. I'm Nicole Erdix, and I'm here with Terry Morrow.
Hello.
And Catherine Holeko.
Hello.
As moms of teens and young adults, we've survived those little kid days, yet we're still rethinking the decisions that we've made all through our kids' lives and worrying what's going on right now. Today's Thursday, which means it's time to give in to our obsessing about parenting details, big and small, like that double-edged sword of our kids achieving things or not achieving them.
Yeah.
So it's one of those, be careful of what you wish for.
Yeah.
You know, do you want them to do it? Are you glad they didn't do it?
Mm-hmm.
It's just that
secretly
struggle I think we have, a lot of us have, and at some point in our parenting lives. And my kind of story that goes along with this topic is that, you know, after this past year of talking about my daughter getting into university
and being so determined and upset when it didn't happen just the way you wanted, and now how's that working out for you, Nicole?
I'm like, oh, I wish she was home.
Why did I let her go so far away?
I know. Why? And somebody, I read it or heard somebody, but they were, you know, like, it's so odd that as parents, we push and push and push them to be independent, mm-hmm. when they are, it's like, we don't want you to be independent. Come back.
Yeah.
So
I always felt like my mom really got bit by that, because she raised me to be independent and then off I went. And I think where'd you go? Come back.
Think this through.
That's right.
Yeah. What was I thinking when I said that, you know, another country would be okay?
Yeah. Oh.
But no, it's not actually that bad. I mean, technology certainly helps, but definitely I know that there's that feeling of, oh, you know, I'm really happy that she's gone away, but it would have been nice if she was close to home.
Yeah.
Oh,
that is
rough. I mean, it was so close to being like that, right? Like where she was going to stay home for another year or two.
Yeah, we had all sorts of options in place for her to be closer to home.
And then, hooray, this came through.
Yeah. Yay. So, Terry, what about you? What was your, you had something that happened to you recently?
Oh, I mean, lately, I think I spoke about this last week, that my son, who's now 26, has decided, after many years of being completely disinterested, that he wanted to drive, which, yay, from a developmental point of view. So happy. That's wonderful that he wants to do that. And at the same time, no. Constant chorus in my head of no. But, you know, you got to encourage it. I, you know, never want to say, no, honey, you can't do that. That's impossible. So, you know, we had the written test is the first hurdle. So he did go and take the written test, and he failed. So he was going to go back the following week and do it again, and he decided he needed to study more. So I don't know whether this is going to continue to be a thing or it's going to take some time off. I think once he is absolutely ready for it, he will do it, and it will be perfect, and there will be no problems. This has been basically the way he's made developmental leaps all his life. It takes a long time, and then when he's ready, boom.
Right.
So this is a sign probably that he's not ready. And, you know, on the one hand, I'm disappointed for him, and it's, you know, it's hard to get something in your head and then try for it and have it not work out. And it's like, part of me thinks he should keep going and taking the test. He should keep trying. You don't want to give up. And part of me is saying, thank goodness I don't have to worry about this right now. So it's, you know, it's hard, because you want your kids to do brave things. You want them to be bold. You want them to grab the things that they dream of. And then at the same time, you want to wrap them in bubble wrap and keep them in the closet. So it's, you know, I have those conflicting feelings quite a lot.
Yeah, most definitely.
So, you know, my daughter drives, and I'm so proud of her for doing it. And she's a very, very good driver. But, man, every time she leaves the house, I get on my knees and say a prayer. So, lots of rosaries in the pursuit of my children being independent.
Yeah.
So,
what about you, Catherine? Have you had anything recently that comes to mind?
Well, I mean, it's certainly the college thing. You know, people keep asking me where she's going to apply. And as of right now, there's nothing within about I don't know, 300 miles. Like, they're all right. Far away. And then the response is, I was like, oh, like, she's going to be so far. I'm like, I know. Stop.
Yeah.
Like, well, I don't know. My dad circled a map and said, within this radius, are you able to do that?
Not really, because it's all about skating.
Oh, that's true.
The schools that have a very particular team and competitive level. And so it's, none of them are here. So.
Yes.
How far away is it?
I would have to, I don't know off the top of my head, but the closest ones are in Michigan. So they're like a good 6+ hour drive. I mean, partly because you have to go to Chicago or swim through Lake Michigan. Yeah. So either way, it's a little tough. So yeah. You know?
That's simultaneously exciting and terrifying.
So, and I could definitely see it, you know, when my daughter started to drive, you know, discuss carpooling yesterday. It was a great relief for that. But at the same time, it's like, oh my God, she's getting in the car today. Yeah. And it'll be the same with my son. Like, we got a letter about driver's ed. And it's like, oh my God, you know, he's too young for that. And then, it basically said, you know, these are the dates that we're having the classroom instruction, mm-hmm. and your kid has to be 15 by the time, you know, to enter the classroom. The child has to be 15, and he wouldn't be 15 for any of those. So I'm like, throwing this away. Like, does not apply.
Little reprieve. Well, as I tell both my kids, it's not their driving abilities that I worry about.
Yeah,
it's the crazy people on the roads. Mm-hmm. So you have to not only drive well yourself, but you have to anticipate somebody coming into that lane that's empty, going 150 miles an hour on Route 80. Yeah. And, you know, even just getting out of we live on a cul-de-sac that empties onto a street. The speed limit is 25, but that's, you know, people drive 20, 30 miles an hour over that easily.
Mm-hmm.
And there's people park illegally so that you can't see as you're coming out. So you have to pretty much look as good as you can and then just floor it and say a prayer and hope that there's nobody coming, because you can't see them and they're coming fast. Yeah. They're coming ridiculously fast. So it's like, can I even be comfortable with my son learning to like turn out of our street? It's like, honey, can we drive you partway there and then you can take the wheel? It's like, my daughter makes a left turn there every day to go to work, and it's just, I try not to think about it because it's so
terrifying.
Bad. We had like the largest, speed trap on our street yesterday. I think in history, there was like 8 or 10 police officers with a radar gun, and they were just bringing the cars in.
Oh, nice. Wow.
I think they did their quota for the entire month of September and possibly October. So anytime, come back anytime, right, gentlemen. We're very happy to see you. Yes. Thank you, officers.
Wow. Yeah, we have one of those two down the street, but they're putting in traffic lights. Thank goodness.
I wish they would put a traffic light at ours, even though we're just a little cul-de-sac, but there's no other way for us to go. You know, we have to turn there. I'm very sorry. But speed bumps possibly would be good.
Yeah.
I can't believe how fast people drive on this street. I mean, it's a nice straight street, and I think people just, with no signals, I think people say, oh, good, I can make up some time. But, you know, there's people trying to turn. There's a high school, you know. There's a school here with kids darting across the street. You might want to just put on the brake a little bit. I digress.
Does your town have those, like, shaming, you know, signs?
Oh, yeah.
They need it, but I think people would just take that as a dare, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
They used to have that at my husband's, like, office complex, you know?
Yeah.
They would have those, your speed is, and people would literally be like, how high can I get that?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
That is that number.
Absolutely what would happen on this street. You know, I mean, even at trying to turn onto my street, people like tailgate me like, well, I got to slow down to turn, y'all.
Right. backed off.
Yeah, it's so bad. Mm-hmm. But anyway, so that's the problem. It's not like you don't trust your child, although maybe you don't. But even if you do trust your child, there's so many people out there that you don't trust.
Yeah.
So, you know, on the one hand, I'm sad when my daughter is staying home and not going out and doing things. And on the other hand, it's like, thank goodness I know where she is. Here, honey, let me give you a little money for YouTube. That's good. So, you know, here, buy something else from Apple to watch. It's fine. Here's, I'll buy you a Netflix membership. Stay right where you are.
Exactly.
That's bad, though. I recognize that's bad. And yet I'm still going to do it.
Well, I'm sure that we will be able to revisit this topic because these things happen and they keep happening.
Yes, they do.
Yeah.
So, but that'll be it for today's round four. Tune in tomorrow when we'll share our roundabout roundup of things we've been using or enjoying lately that we think deserve a shout out. Find all our episodes at parentingroundabout.com and talk back in the comments there on our Facebook page or on Twitter, where you'll find us at Roundabout Chat.